this tutorial, we will see the last two editors of CDesign, the Terra Web Editor and the Pico Configuration Editor. Okay, I have already opened CDesign. Let's select the configuration we want to edit. As usual, chiller for compressors. Select Terra Web Editor. So Terra is a cloud service that is the current solution for the remote monitoring of the current product for air conditioning and refrigeration. It is not the purpose of this tutorial to present Terra. So if you are interested in this product, you can contact your local Carel representative. So in this part there are some configuration parameters for the Terra. Configuration name, configuration version. So who knows Terra perfectly knows the purpose of this parameter. The interesting part is the bottom part where there are the variables that we can exchange with Terra and the web server. As usual, you can see here what variable. There isn't a flag, a specific flag in the global variable, but you see here the variables that are set as protocol, dev, dev, as log, as alarms. So what we can do here is just select, so disable or set only read or set read write the variables we want to exchange with Terra and the web with the web server. For example, for the temperature. There is the water in the temperature for the web server is disabled, so we could set it just read. With this button it is possible to update the descriptions, because if later you change this description, when you enter here the system doesn't update them automatically. So to update them you have to force the update using this button. As usual, you can export, import this list of variables in order to, for example, use it in another configuration or to use it in other tools like KSet, LonSet, BugSet, and so on. Later in another tutorial we will check if the variables that we want to show in the web server have the right flag here, read or read write. For now, for this editor, it's enough. Next one, CPico Configuration Editor. Here there are sub configurations, so we can start from the first. The first regards IP in general. All options, or almost all sub configurations, have an option use system default. To know what are the values used as default, you can see as usual the online help of CDesign as well as the quick reference. So here are for the network that is the one that we are going to see. The host name is empty, the obtained IP address is set automatically, that is in DHCP, and so on. So we can have a very short description of this parameter. So the host name, like my chiller, allows to define the host name of this controller. This let you, just to give you an idea, to write here rather than the IP of the controller, my chiller. But to do this we have to configure the local network where the controller is connected, this PC is connected. Must be connected to a DNS server that is able to translate this name, this host name, with the real IP address of the controller. So for more information you can contact the IT manager of your company. Next, obtain an IP address automatically or use the following IP address. So basically this set CPico with the DHCP on or with a specific address. these parameters correspond to what you can write, what you can set here in the TCP IP settings. So it's this option and also these ones. Okay, I leave in with the systems. Terminal address. This regards the configuration of the PGD1 external terminals. Well, each Pico can show its mask into up to 3 external terminals. The controller has an address in this network that is called PLAN. For example, in this case there are 2 CPICO, address 1 and 2, and then 3 terminals. The terminals can be configured as private or shared. Private for a specific device, like 1 in this case, or shared by 2 or more. In this example, this CPICO address 1, oh sorry, let's start from this part. In this case, this terminal is configured as private of terminal 1, so here I will see only the mask of this device, this CPICO. This is configured private of 2, so here I will see the mask only of this one, and this one is configured as shared by the 2. So somehow, that is using a system menu or using some system function in CMask, it is possible to show the mask of the unit 1, this one, or number 2. From the point of view of this controller, so this controller, this PICO address 1, or uses 2 terminals, this one as private and this one as shared. Also this one, address 2, will have 2 terminals, this one and this one as shared. For more details, as written here, regarding the terminal configuration, you can see the manual of CPICO system. There is a chapter specific for the configuration of the terminals. So to configure a controller according to this example, we have to set in the first case the PICO address 1, the first terminal, doesn't matter the order, the first terminal has address 3 as private and the second is the 32 as shared. 3 as private for number 1 and 32 shared for the number 1. For the second would be something like this. In this case is the number 4 that is private. Number 4 that is private for number 2. Next, users and protection regards the same topic, that is protection, but there is a specific tutorial regarding this topic. So next is a server, where we can set the web port and FTP port for the web and FTP protocol. The last configuration regards the system clock. So the internal real-time clock is not perfect, so it is subject to a, let's say, time drift, that is every week, every month, year, it can go some second ahead, back or forth. So maybe necessary to synchronize it with the exact time and date. So there are 3 options to synchronize it. The first is manual, that is the user that has manually to synchronize it using, for example, the system mask setting clock. So here in a mask like this, as well as in the application, that is, for example, the project template as in the settings submenu, here is the time and date, where we can change the time and date. So first option is manual. Second option is NTP. NTP, that is using NTP protocol and NTP server. NTP are servers that are NTP free NTP stands for Network Time Protocol. Here is, so there are servers, also free servers like this, that provides the exact time and date. So we can write the IP, it works also with the name here. So every day the CPICO inquires this server and receives the exact time and date. Third option is Tera, that I mentioned before. In this case, the CPICO inquires Tera. Tera has the right time because it's Tera that is synchronized with its NTP server. Next is a time zone. So we are talking about daylight saving time. So for example, if I select this time zone, the system is able to correctly manage the local time. It is able to manage the daylight saving time, that is change the hour. For example, in this case, the last Sunday of March and the last Sunday of October. There is also a custom rule. Okay, this is a very, very particular case. That is, in event, for example, the European Community tomorrow decide to change the rules, to change the time. That is, instead of the last Sunday of October, is the last Sunday of September. In this case, to install this configuration in the controller, you have to wait that the Karel release a new version of the operating system with these new rules. The alternative is use a custom rule, because somehow here is written that the time changed by 1 hour should be this one, by 1 hour, the last Sunday of March should be this one, and the last Sunday of October, that is this. So we have to write here the new rule. This is a standard rule, so if you are curious, copy, we can search here in internet. You see here what are the rules, and here are the rules to change the time in these regions. Okay, let me set back all the defaults. Well, that's all also for this editor. It is also all for C-Design. In the next tutorial, we will start to see the last tool, that is C-Factory.